You can't heal the areas that you've suppressed and the emotions that you try not to express. In order for you to heal, you have to feel. Falling in love. Hey y'all, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is T Marie, and on today's video, I'm going to share 5 tips to feel in order for you to heal. So number 1 is soul cry. You have to go deeper than the surface and heal the things that you never wanted to reveal. You have to ask God to search your soul for anything that you have not yet grieved so that you can let go of it. Because the hidden things can be of hindrance to you without you even knowing. And they can be the childhood trauma, the friendship or relationship breakups, being in survival mode majority of your life and having to raise yourself and probably having to raise others too. And all of that can lead to abandonment, isolation issues, depression, anger, and some things you've never given yourself permission to cry. Because you had to keep going. But in order for you to heal, you have to feel. And I remember the first time that I cried here in my new apartment. It was New Year's Eve, y'all. So I was only here for probably not even that long. But I had just moved in. And I made myself breakfast. I came to my bedroom. I had my little breakfast stand or whatever. You know how you can eat in your bed. And I was watching a sermon. Then I just immediately started crying. And it wasn't because of the sermon that I was watching, so I had to mute the TV. And I had to just allow my soul to feel whatever it was feeling. And I was crying, and I never experienced this type of cry before. Like, I've cried so many different tears, you know, throughout the years of my life. Tears of, you know, hurt, rejection, breakups, friendship breakups, relationship breakups, you know, just trying to figure life out in general. So many different tears that you cry. But this cry, I've never cried this cry before. And it was almost like my soul was like releasing whatever was holding me down for so many years. It was like a release. And God had told me it was because you finally moved from survival mode into safety. And after I heard that, I just started crying even more. Like, I lost my appetite and everything. I made breakfast, eggs got cold, but whatever. But that cry, I just allowed my soul to release that cry and release the things that I was feeling. And it wasn't a sad cry or anything like that. It was almost like tears of gratitude. Like, thank you, God, that you heard my cry. And I felt safe while crying in this place because I felt God's presence with me. It was almost like he was collecting every tear that I was crying, just like that Bible verse said, like, God will collect the tears that you cry when you don't have the words to say. And I didn't have the words to say, but my heart was just so grateful. It was filled with so much gratitude, and like, he answered. I was in an answered blessing, something that I was previously crying about in my last season. Now my tears changed. Like, now I'm crying about God coming through and God really showing up, and that God heard me in those dark nights, middle of the nights, crying, waiting for God to come through, and he actually did. So when I released that cry, I allowed my soul to actually feel it. And it felt so good to be crying a different type of cry, like different tears. Like, these tears weren't tears of sadness, but of gratitude. And that's just a different type of cry when God comes through for you and all you can do is say thank you by tears. Like, all you can do is say thank you by crying. But I'm a crybaby, so I'm sure God knows me. God knows my heart. But yeah, that was just my first time experiencing my soul actually cry. So yeah, he said I moved out of survival mode into safety. So like I said, when you allow your soul to cry, and once you get into God's presence, you're going to feel safe with releasing your tears to him, because God's presence is a safe place. Number 2 is release to replace. So after you release the negative emotions, you want to replace them with positive emotions. And this reminds me of the Bible scripture, Matthew 12:43-45. And it says, when an evil spirit leaves, it's going to go searching for rest in a new home, meaning a new person. And if it can't find rest, then it's going to return back to the home that it came from, only if their home is empty and unoccupied. So if you release those negative emotions and those spirits and you don't fill your home with the Holy Spirit, then when those spirits come back, they're going to come back not only by themselves, but they're going to come back with spirits even worse than themselves, as the Bible says. So you want to make sure that you fill your house with the Holy Spirit, because emotions can also be the doorway or gateway to spirits. And you don't want your home to be empty or unoccupied when they attempt to come. That's like leaving the door open after you put your man out for whatever reason. You leave the door open and he comes back in now with his homeboys. So you just let go of your narcissist boyfriend, your narcissist, the spirit, and he comes back with anger, depression, anxiety. No, once that door is closed, once you release them, you want to fill your home with God, the presence of God, the peace of God, the Holy Spirit. So it's important that once you release those negative emotions, that you replace them with positive ones. And on a spiritual level, once you release those spirits that are causing the unwanted emotions, that you replace them with the Holy Spirit. That way, when they attempt to come back, their access to you will be denied. And that's because you'll now be under the power and protection of God and His Holy Spirit. Number three is, it's in your mind. So the Bible says to take every thought captive and bring it to the obedience of Christ. So it's important to discern and identify what thoughts and emotions are of God and which ones are not. And you take them captive by rebuking them by the power of God and the authority that God has given you. And the Bible also says, be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So once your mind is renewed, you don't want to go back to your old ways of thinking, because those thoughts can welcome emotions and cause you to feel in areas that you already healed. Number four is, fight what you feel. So when those thoughts and emotions do try to creep back up, or you find yourself becoming easily triggered again, you gotta fight what you feel, meaning it's time to go to war about your peace. And how do you go to war? By way of worship, prayer, and fasting. And how do you fight? You fight by keeping your faith, and you're going to win every time, because God don't take no losses. And y'all, God reminded me of a video that I did like 2 years ago on this topic. And I just love that He's allowing me to like repurpose my content, because then I did not know that I would use those videos for now, but they are so on point. And even though I gave those videos out or posted those videos so many years ago, it's like they still stand with God. Like God will literally remind me of the words that I spoke. So I'm gonna post that video here and we're gonna come back. Imagine you standing in a boxing ring and you're not fighting back. It's you versus depression. It's you versus anxiety. And it's you versus suicide. And it just feels like you're losing. Well, that was me. But then I messed around and got a trainer, Coach Jesus. And him and his assistant, Holy Spirit, let me know that I was looking at it all wrong. That it's not a physical fight, but a spiritual one. It's not a physical fight, but a spiritual one. And that the word of God says, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, spiritual wickedness, and rulers of darkness in this world. So they let me know, in order for you to win this battle, that you gotta put on the full armor of God. So I was in the ring, but I didn't really know what I was up against. But because God said that this is a spiritual fight, He said that this kind only comes out by prayer and fasting. So I began to do just that. And I knew that if life and death is in the power of the tongue and suicide is coming after me, I had to speak life. I had to open my mouth and speak life back to that dead situation. Well, I'm still alive, so we know who won that battle. And I share that to say this. God said it's time for you to get back in the ring. That you still got some fight in you.
that there's a war that you need to win against yourself. And God said, just like the three Hebrew boys, that they were not in the fight alone, God said, you will not be in the ring alone, that he will fight this battle with you. But it's time for you to get back in the ring and win this battle against yourself. So now that you know what you know, we battle not against flesh and blood. Now that you know what you know, this kind only comes out by prayer and fasting. Now that you know what you know, you got to put on the full armor of God. Now that you know, what you going to do with it? Either you going to win or you going to win. No more losses. God said it's time to get back in the ring.
So yeah, sometimes you might have to fight what you feel in order for you to heal. And I know for me, a lot of people would ask, like, how am I so peaceful, or how is my presence so peaceful? It's because I had to go to war about my peace. And you might have to do the same, but you have to know that it is not a physical fight, but a spiritual one. And when you do become ready for battle and ready for war, you need to know that that war is already won by God, because again, he don't take no losses, and neither will you. Number 5, and the last one, is sense the season. Meaning, what do you feel that God is trying to reveal to you in this season? And if you don't know, you can always go to God and ask him, what is it that he needs you to learn or gain in this season? And who is he building you to become? Like the Bible says, the affliction was good for me. So God may be trying to teach you something while you're in your emotions or while you're in that hurt place, but the hurt can no longer hinder you. So you have to ask God to help you to navigate through that healing process so that you can heal from the things that you feel. So remember, in order for you to heal, you have to feel. And know that crying is a form of deliverance, because it's a way that the soul releases. And you have to go to war about your peace, but it's a spiritual fight and not a physical one. Remember to replace all negative emotions with positive ones. So y'all, with that being said, this is the end of the video. If y'all have any topics that y'all want me to speak on, please drop them in the comments below, because we're growing in Christ together, y'all. We're growing in God together. So with that being said, make sure that y'all like, comment, and y'all subscribe. And remember, in order for you to heal, you have to feel.